Hi, it's me, Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut. NASA's considering sending a nuclear-powered, flying, robotic, laser-guided quadcopter drone to a world with oceans, rain, and maybe one of the best views in our solar system. That's right. This is one of two potential missions that NASA has narrowed down for their final mission in their New Frontiers program. Today, I'm going to tell you all about one of those two missions as I go head-to-head against the publisher of Universe Today, Fraser Cain, in a battle for the best potential mission. After you've heard from both of us, you get to vote on which one you think should win, which will almost certainly forever shape the history of space exploration. Either that or NASA won't care at all what we think. Well, anyway, here's what Fraser has to say. This better be good.
I'm Fraser Cain, publisher of Universe Today and the host of The Guide to Space. Tim is going to convince you that NASA should choose a nuclear-powered helicopter for Titan. And while I think that's an awesome idea, it's my job to convince you that a comet sample return makes more sense. So after you've heard Tim's argument, come on over to my channel and I'll make the case for a comet sample return. Then, vote.
Wait. You're telling me you want to scoop up some boring old space dirt and bring it home? You've got a real uphill battle on this one. Nuclear, powered, flying, drone versus space dirt. Well, let's get started.
3, 2, 1, 0, 1, 4, 2, 1.
In December of 2017, NASA narrowed down its potential upcoming planetary science missions to just two. The Comet Astrobiology Exploration Sample Return, or CSER, a mission that would return to Comet 67P, that exact same comet that Rosetta and Philae recently flew to. It would then scoop up some comet dirt and bring it back to Earth. The other option is Dragonfly, a nuclear-powered quadcopter that would fly around in the thick atmosphere of Saturn's moon Titan, efficiently exploring more of this incredible world than any other interplanetary mission. Unfortunately, there's only room for one mission. Each team will continue to perfect their proposals until NASA makes their final decision mid-2019. If all goes well, NASA would be able to launch the winning mission as early as 2024. Before we get into the details of the Dragonfly space drone, let's talk about its destination first. Titan. Titan is amazing. Seriously, after researching for this video, I realized how incredible Titan is. And now, more than ever, I really, really want to explore it. Titan is the largest moon orbiting Saturn and the second largest moon in our solar system. Titan is even larger than the planet Mercury. This thing is huge. In some ways, Titan is the most Earth-like body in our solar system. It's actually kind of the most potentially habitable for us humans, too. And there's a remote possibility it could be teeming with super unique alien life. Maybe. Titan has a thick atmosphere. Like, a really thick atmosphere. It's 1.45 times thicker than here on Earth, which means you could go outside without a spacesuit. But there's two reasons why you wouldn't want to do that. First, you'd better bring the warmest coat imaginable, as it's minus 180 degrees Celsius or minus 292 degrees Fahrenheit. Brr. Also, you'll need to bring some oxygen since Titan's atmosphere is almost entirely nitrogen with some methane and some hydrogen. And with its super thick atmosphere and low gravity close to our own moons, you'd actually be able to strap on some wings, flap your arms, and fly around Titan like a bird. Sign me up. It'd probably be a lot better than this guy's attempts here on Earth. And unlike other potentially habitable-ish planets like Mars or our own moon, Titan's thick atmosphere and Saturn's massive magnetosphere could protect life from dangerous galactic cosmic rays and other dangerous radiation. And despite its freezing cold temperatures, due to its thick atmosphere, we wouldn't require a crazy big and vacuum-sealed habitat. Habitats could actually be more like a heated plastic tent, which could be lightweight and maybe even be manufactured using resources right there on Titan. If we were to try and inhabit the moon or Mars permanently, we'd either need massively shielded habitats or live entirely underground to protect us long term. That doesn't sound too fun, does it? Okay, so far Titan doesn't sound anything like Earth, but here's where things get interesting. The craziest part about Titan is it has liquid oceans. But instead of those liquid oceans being liquid water, they're actually liquid methane. And this is one of those things that was kind of hard for me to grasp, but let's take water here on Earth as an example first. Earth is the right temperature to have liquid water. If Earth was any warmer, like a lot warmer, all of that water would boil off and evaporate into a gas. If Earth was a lot colder, all that water would freeze and become a solid, otherwise known as ice. And like all matter, methane exists in one of five states. But let's just stick to the three we're most familiar with: liquids, solids, and gases. Due to the Titan being so cold, methane exists as a liquid, which it does below minus 161 degrees Celsius or minus 257 degrees Fahrenheit. And above that temperature, it's a gas, like we may be more familiar with it here on Earth. And although there isn't liquid water on the surface of Titan, there is water trapped below the crust of Titan. This is exciting not only for the possibility of potential life as we know it down there, but also as means of survival for potential human exploration. Speaking of life, don't forget, here on Earth, we've only ever observed life in the presence of water. All life on Earth requires the presence of liquid water to exist. This is because water is the lubricant for the molecular process of all known life. But maybe in my overly optimistic outlook, there's one key word here that gets me excited: known life. Some scientists hypothesize that life could potentially exist using a molecule called acrylonitrile that could act as a lubricant instead of water. But really, we just simply don't know until we observe otherwise. But in my opinion, how absolutely incredible would it be if someday we discover life as we don't know it? Life that's nothing like here on Earth. Life that's so different, it makes Hollywood's depictions of alien life seem downright hilarious. Okay, so Titan's a super crazy cool world. So now let's talk about exploring Titan. Tell us about that drone, Tim. Okay, the drone would have a leash to walk Titan dogs like this. Okay, well, actually not at all, but it would look like this. Dragonfly has 8 propellers in an X8 configuration. This allows for multi-motor out capability, assuming you don't lose both motors on the same arm. As we've mentioned, due to Titan's thick atmosphere and low gravity, flying around Titan would be super easy. It'd be a very efficient and extremely safe way to explore. With nothing to run into besides potential space pterodactyls, this drone could easily cover tens, if not hundreds of kilometers within its 2-year planned lifespan. That's an insane amount of potential exploration. A big change from previous land roving rovers. The current record holder for the furthest distance traveled on another body is NASA's plucky Mars Opportunity rover, which has traveled 45 kilometers or 28 miles as of January 2018. It's taken Opportunity over 14 years to travel that far though, so it's not what I'd call quick. Before Opportunity, the previous record holder was the USSR's Lunokhod 2 moon rover, which traveled 39 kilometers or 24 miles in 1973 over its 4-month mission. Lunokhod 2 broke the previous record held by 2 humans. That's right, the Apollo 17 lunar rover piloted by Harrison Schmitt and Eugene Cernan traveled pretty darn far. A respectable 35.7 kilometers or 22 miles on the surface of the moon in less than 3 days. That's pretty quick. Another thing that's cool about Dragonfly is it would be powered by a small nuclear generator, specifically a radioisotope thermoelectric generator, or RTG. It'd actually be the exact same RTG that powers the awesome Curiosity Mars rover. RTGs convert the heat of decaying radioactive material into electricity. The excess heat would also be pumped back into the body of the drone to keep its electronics at a comfortable room temperature. A win-win. The RTG would recharge the onboard battery, which actually powers the drone. This allows the drone to fly around for the duration of the battery and then land and recharge, even during Titan's night, which lasts 8 Earth days. But maybe one of the most exciting things is Dragonfly can measure bulk element surface composition with a neutron-activated gamma ray spectrometer and monitor atmospheric and surface conditions, including diurnal and spatial variations with meteorology sensors. I have no idea. It's cool stuff, probably. Good thing I'm not in the planning team, because I'd probably just say, put lasers on it and make sure it can do some cool barrel rolls. Although the Dragonfly mission would be super exciting, it wouldn't actually be the first mission to the surface of Titan. Nope. On January 14th, 2005, the Huygens probe successfully touched down on the surface of Titan. Although the Huygens spacecraft only lasted 90 minutes on the surface of Titan, it still provided very useful data about the conditions, paving the way for further exploration. Huygens launched alongside the wonderful Cassini spacecraft, which studied the Saturn system for 14 years, just recently ending its incredibly fruitful mission in September 2017. Man, I'm so excited about a drone flying around Titan and potentially making some incredible discoveries. So what do you think? Are you a fan of Titan and or Dragonfly? Do you want us to explore Titan further? If not, where do you want to explore next? Let me know in your thoughts below. And although he's going to have a really hard time convincing us of why Caesar is even remotely worth considering, we do need to remember to head on over to Fraser Cain's channel to learn more about what NASA's other option is. While you're at it, make sure and check out his entire channel. As the publisher of Universe Today, Fraser's content is bursting with amazingly well-researched topics. As a matter of fact, I watched his videos to learn more about Titan for today's video. So once you've watched both of our videos, be sure and hit the link in the description to cast your vote. I owe a special thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping make this and other everyday astronaut content possible. I owe an extra special thanks to those patrons in our exclusive Discord channel for helping me script and research. If you want to help contribute, hang out in our exclusive Discord channel, or offer ideas in our exclusive subreddit, please visit patreon.com/everydayastronaut. Thank you. Don't forget to check out my web store for shirts, hats, mugs, prints of rocket launches, original artwork, and lots of other fun stuff at everydayastronaut.com/shop. And as always, all the music in my videos is original. The song in this video is called Jovian Moonrun. Feel free to check it out and download it for free at soundcloud.com/everydayastronaut. Tell a friend. Thanks, everybody. That does it for me. I'm Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, bringing space down to Earth for everyday people.